Seth Jones on the ice as well for the Columbus Blue Jackets. He scored the lone Blue Jackets goal in a 3-1 Tampa Bay win here on Thursday night between these two teams. And then Chernak able to get it over and across the line. Ross Colton coming in with a chance and a save from Korpisalo. Still the power play with 20 seconds left on it. Tampa Bay has some awfully good looks, but it's still scoreless.
And I think that with that success, it's come, they're really aggressive, and that's where...
A little too much behind it from Max Domi. Atkinson sends it out high. That one kicked away off the shot that came from Delzato. His point cutting in. Barré-Boulet shot it wide. Then Shen goes back to the net, stopped by Korpisalo. Pressure continues. Braden Point spinning, looking. Palat, he scores! The short side shot by Andre Palat into the roof of the net opens the scoring for Tampa.
Out from Luke Shen, and it's just hard work from Braden Point and then a good position there. Good work on the forecheck, but it's really on that zone entry how they created that.
Yeah, Tampa has had a lot of ozone possession time to start this game, but a lot of it was perimeter and that entry. It was Point that got the puck.
He was back in the lineup on Thursday, played almost 16 minutes after being a healthy scratch in back-to-back games. For John Tortorella, this one bounced out to the front. They score! Off Vasilevsky, it's set up for Grigorenko, and the Blue Jackets have tied it late in the first.
It seems like...
off win, and then look at them go to work. There's net front presence there, a long shot, and then it's just a gritty goal. They're getting to the middle there, and they're taking advantage of what, Dom, you and I were just talking about, the defensemen losing their mark.
Yeah, it just was a matter of time, it felt like, before this was going to cost them, and obviously this is a team.
Looking, brings it around the back of the net, circling still. Domi finds a pass and then got it back. That one knocked down at the front of the net. Rolling through off the stick of Bjorkstrand. Now it's Robinson getting free. He scores! Erik Robinson popped out from below the goal line. And with 31 seconds to play in the period, it is 2-1 Blue Jackets.
Look at the way that they're playing. They're forechecking. They're jumping on the puck. And it's just that one-on-one battle. That's all it is. It's hard work and you're battling against... A player back there, Gord, and he jumps out, and it's just a wraparound goal. When you look at the way that that first goal just lit a fire under this Columbus Blue Jacket, you knew that they were ready for a second one. Good timing for them.
Atkinson will move it with Jones already headed that way. He'll continue it on the forecheck. Left wing wall, Palat, Braden Point, full head of steam. He's got Matthew Joseph to the goal. Point cutting, and they score! A tap-in for Matthew Joseph off the setup for Braden Point, and it's tied at two.
Just a phenomenal breakout pass from Andre Palat. Just a no-look pass, rink wide, to Braden Point, and then it's Matthew Joseph with that great speed. And sometimes you wonder how to create offense, and it starts with breakouts. And when you've got a team that's this good in transition, Point just knows that Palat has eyes in the back of his head. He knew he would find him, and then Joseph knows as well, a playmaker like Point.
Right back it comes for Point, stepping, dropped it offside of the net. Barré-Boulet with a shot that ramped up off Korpisalo. Palat.
Atkinson has four shorties, so it's been a tough year in Columbus, as we said.
Oh, this is a giveaway and a great play by Jones to disrupt it, and a couple of saves for Korpisalo required on the shorthanded chance for Blake Coleman.
Play, the puck just ends up on the stick of Blake Coleman, and he quick move to the forehand, but
power play is over for Columbus. Meanwhile, it's Joseph coming back in. There was a rebound that was shot through Korpisalo and cleaned up by Lettinen. A glorious chance just feet away from the goal, and no one within feet of him. Here's Sorelli popping out, turning on net. That one juggled and covered for a moment. Jarred free by Killorn, who got a little extra. 3 minutes to go here in the second period. Stretch pass on. Josh Dunn to the front. And there is no rebound coming that time from Andre Vasilevsky. Closing in on him was Sorelli. As Lettinen left the puck behind, Sorelli takes over. Rims it around. McDonough trying to go back to Sorelli. Directed by Roslovic. Sorelli finds it, cuts to the net on the backhand. Now turns to the forehand. And a glove stop comes from Korpisalo.
And it's McDonough that kind of draws the puck to the middle, and it was a good stick from Roslovich, but Cirelli gets away from him, and then a quick move, and then a spinorama.
That's how drastic the amount of practice time that's been reduced for the Tampa Bay Lightning and for everybody around the National Hockey League. That it's not even close to what he gets in a normal schedule, as this one is Domi's shot blocked by Chernak. And Robinson scores! Eric Robinson found a loose puck, put it off the far post and in. And on the opening minute of the third period, the Blue Jackets take back the lead.
You look at the way that this play developed, and it's almost like the Tampa Bay Lightning. We just talked about the speed they came with in the second period. They're standing around. All of them are standing around. There's a block shot, not knowing what to go. I think Vasilevskiy's going to want this one back. He's screened a little bit from Bjorkstrand right there, a moving screen, but that's unusual for Vasilevskiy.
To the left side, Barré-Boulet, backdoor play for point, disrupted by Jones. Korpisalo, he might be hurt here. Korpisalo a little slow, and they set up Barré-Boulet. It's a power play goal. It's his first in the NHL.
Thinking about Barré-Boulet, who succeeded at every single level, but still, despite all the opportunity, not been able to score his first. And here, a beautiful shot.
In point now, Killorn turns and shoots. Blocked by Gavrikov. Comes from Barré-Boulet. Got in with a rising shot that's fought off by Merzlikins. And cleared off the stick of Hedman. Sip pulled it out. Played to Savard. Savard, a blind pass. Came to Roslovic. Roslovic cutting in on Vasilevskiy. Made the save. And a frustrated Jack Roslovic takes it out on the glass just next to the referee. Roslovic. Andre Vasilevskiy comes up with the save to keep it tied at three. Pass. Chernak had to adjust. He gets bumped off. And the puck continued on for Matthew Joseph. Joseph takes a hard hit from Gerby. And Gerby took a hard hit from Maroon as they sent it through the paint. Seconds left. Gavrikov will do the same as he brings it down low, sent back up the wall, and overtime required tonight in Tampa.
Vitamin D's, you know, underrated.
Overtime here, right off the faceoff. Jones had to sweep that one away from point with his glove. Point sets up Hedman with a shot. He scores! 10 seconds into overtime, Hedman wins it for the Lightning.
Seconds, and look at that. Victor Hedman, who's been struggling as of late, he gets his eye, moves into that space, he finds it. Great setup by Braden Point. We've talked about him before, already had 2 assists, and there's his third assist on the game-winning goal in overtime.
And Point and Palat so dangerous tonight. They really drive the bus up front, and it's this guy Victor Hedman that drives the bus on the defensive side for Tampa. And another OT winner, he had one last week. And Tampa again.